Hey everybody, this is Jeremiah Craig, and I am just outside of the jungle. I'm getting ready to play my first show with the Rusty Crowbars, my new band, and I got a new pair of boots to do it in. In fact, it's the first Jeremiah Craig boot made by BNV Boots. You guys are not ready for this. Let's get into it. I am outside the jungle, ready to play my first show with my new band, the Rusty Crowbars, and I have a spectacular pair of boots to do it in. Whoa, wait a minute now. I'm getting ahead of myself, so let's rewind. I am so excited to talk to you about the first Jeremiah Craig Cowboy boot, but first, I feel like I need to put a few things in context. It all starts with music. Music has been such an important part of my life. I was singing as a child. I started playing the banjo in high school. Then I learned the harmonica and the guitar. And then I started writing songs and getting serious about music and pursuing it as a career about the same time that I started wearing cowboy boots. I was writing songs, performing in bands, going on tour, but when the bands didn't work out, I started my own solo music career in 2011. Before I released my first album, I wanted to make sure I had a logo that not only summarized who I am, but also reminded me of the path that I was pursuing. And so I made this logo right here. You see it at the beginning of every video. But let's break it down. The logo is comprised of a Celtic double spiral, which symbolizes balance, and a compass needle. So effectively, this means balanced direction in everything. Life, music, promotion, every single thing that you can think of. Balanced direction is key. And what I mean by that in life is you need a firm foundation, a solid ground before you take your first step towards a goal or towards a journey or towards an end result. No matter where you're going, if you want to succeed, you need to have a great family, friends, support group, and you need to spend time with them on a regular basis so that you can be your best self and find your path. So the Balanced Direction Jeremiah Craig logo is a great reminder and inspiration to so many different situations in my life, so I like to put it on everything that I can. And when Jose from BNV Boots contacted me and said he wanted to make the first Jeremiah Craig boot, I knew my logo had to be on it, but I also knew that there were some other little things that had to be in this first boot. And he had a wealth of examples and a wealth of knowledge to share with me on our first phone call where I ordered these Jeremiah Craig boots.
Hello?
Hey Jose, how's it going? This is Jeremiah.
I'm doing great, and you?
I'm doing spectacular. So far, I like the idea of the water buffalo calf with the cognac vamp and the medium brown tops with the logo inlaid into the shaft, and that also be the cognac color.
That is a very nice combo.
Yeah.
Classic.
Yeah, I love it. The pictures that you sent of the Roper boot, for example, that looks really good. And I was also wondering if you could do a J-toe on that.
That is no trouble.
Okay.
J-toe.
What are your lasts like? Like, what is the fit compared to a major brand? I just want to make sure that I give you the right size since I'm not...
That is a great question. You know more than the average customer, so, you know, I'm laying it out to you. But my main last is the R-toe, Justin 2533, and my J-toe's 2007. Those are the serial numbers. They're Justin last.
Okay.
Water buffalo calf, that's baby calf. That's buttery soft. By itself, it's gonna very nicely stretch.
Nice. Okay. Yeah, let's go with the 11.5B then. J-toe with a 1 5/8 cowboy style heel.
1 5/8 The height on the upper, what were you thinking, 12, 13, or you have any preference on two?
Preferably 13, I think.
Do you want a double scallop? We could do the double roast.
No, I don't think I need double scallop. I think just regular, whatever's normal.
Regular. Any preference as to the pull?
Could you make the pull straps also cognac?
Yeah, I was going to say, to match and tie in the BAM.
Yes, I love that idea. After the phone call, the boots took about 3 to 4 weeks to arrive, and during that time, I was wondering if I had chosen correctly with the 11.5B. As the days came closer to the boot actually arriving, I was getting a little bit nervous. But then it finally arrived, and here is the magnificent unboxing. All right, so here they are. This is the first Jeremiah Craig boot. It is such a cool thing to see. My logo in the shaft of this boot. Oh, it makes me smile every time I see it. The leather is very supple. I mean, this is water buffalo calf. The leather lining is really nice, and this is a thin shaft. So I'm kind of wondering how it's gonna break in, but I'm also impressed that it's standing upright. This is the thinnest shaft that I've felt this year. Like, it's super supple. I mean, you just see it. It's just like really bending easily. So I'm kind of wondering how this will settle and if I actually need to invest in my first pair of cedar boot trees to stick in here and actually keep that shaft as tight as possible so it doesn't sag like so many of my other boots do. I absolutely love the colors. It is so nice. And for the inside, where the ball of the foot is, we have a hard leather sole. But on the heel, we have a little bit of leather padding. So that's gonna provide a little bit of shock absorbency that I didn't expect, that is a nice touch. One thing that kind of bums me out though is that there's a little smudge, a little stain on the toe of this right boot. During the finishing process, it looks like some of the stain that was put on this outsole kind of came up here as it was being polished in the final steps, and it stained the toe. So this is there forever now. The toe is now a little bit darker in this spot than the rest of the boot. Another thing that I've noticed that comes with a handmade boot are handmade human imperfections. And we've talked about this before, like on the Lucchese Classics video that I did recently that you can check out above. Handmade boots will have human imperfections. In this boot specifically, it comes with the cutting of the logo and the shape of it. And it really shines in the back of the shaft here. So these cuts are not the same. You can tell that they've been done by hand, and because it's such an intricate design that is kind of tough to cut out, especially at the size that it is, you can see that one side is a little bit broader, a little bit wider, a little bit fatter than the other logo. So the logos aren't the same anywhere on this boot. In fact, I'd have to say that the best one is on the right boot. This is probably the best, most accurate logo cutting out of the four sides of this boot that the logo is featured on. So they're all different, and that comes from a handmade process. We also have a beautiful leather stacked heel. I love the look of this. I like these little dips in the design along the tongue of the boot where the foot meets the shaft. This is a very nice design here as well. The piping is a very nice leather. It's probably one of the thickest leather pipings that I've felt this year. It's great. It feels spectacular right there. and I just absolutely love the toe shape. Now it's time to try this boot on. Now, it is kind of snug. I probably could have gotten away with doing the 12B, but the 11.5B still works, and this leather will stretch. It feels great still, but it does feel a little bit too snug around the toes. This is a absolutely beautiful boot. I love the look of it. I love that toe style too. It just feels great. I'm wondering how this water buffalo calf will break in. I just started a new band here in Boston. We're called Jeremiah Craig and the Rusty Crowbars. And when these arrived, I knew that I had to wear these for our first show. But before that, I wanted to talk with Jose about his magnificent Jeremiah Craig boot. All right, I am with Jose Chavez of BNV Boots. Jose, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you,
this is a really exciting interview and episode. Probably the best one so far because it is such a unique boot. The first Jeremiah Craig boot. Love it. Can you give us a short intro and origin story of what it was like to become a bootmaker and starting BNV Boots?
Back when I started in May of 2001, it grew out of a need to make my own boots. Because off the rack, I have a pretty standard foot, but the toe wasn't there, the shaft wasn't there, the colors weren't there for whatever reason, the heel. So I just started making my own. Bought the last for myself, my size, and I started making for friends. And afterwards, I kept on getting orders and orders, and that's how it evolved.
Oh, wow. Okay, so what about the heel, the shaft, and the other parts of the boots that you can just get off the shelf? What about those things were you not happy with that led you to make your own boots?
The most common is the, in my case, the lining. The point is mine are calf lined. Sometimes some special orders, we even use kangaroo lining. The boot breathes a lot better. You don't get blisters. Here in El Paso, summers are 100 plus. So heat is a big issue. And your feet breathe better. You're more comfortable. Plus you get the design you want, the color you want. The big brands will have a run of 1,000 pairs with a blue with black. You might like the black on the bottom, not the blue on top, whatever the case might be. You just make the pair that you like, how you like, and as comfortable as you like.
Speaking of the lining and the leather, let's talk about what this boot is. This is water buffalo calf, correct?
That is correct. That is water baby or water buffalo calf.
And what is like the advantages and disadvantages of using water buffalo calf?
The suppleness allows it to conform to your foot like a glove, like glove leather. That's pretty much what it is. It's light on you, it conforms to your foot, and it looks very nice. You get a very nice shine to it, and it gets better with age. It's something for every day, definitely not a work boot, but it's a very nice dress boot. You can tone it down with jeans. It won't look bad at all if you wear slacks. Plenty of customers who are lawyers, bankers, doctors, salespeople that suit and tie, and they wear them.
What do you like about the handmade process? Because I imagine there's people on both ends, even when it comes down to the inlay right here. Like I've seen CNC laser cutting machines that cut the leather out, but you will cut this by hand. What do you like most about the handmade process that has kept you in that vein rather than using more technology and the newer machinery?
Like you mentioned, those lasers, they are 100% precise. The problem lays, if you notice, there's a background leather behind that inlay. We skive it, really thin it out by hand. That way it doesn't look like a patch, real thick and heavy. Mm-hmm. And those laser cut, they don't have time to skive the background color.
What does skive mean?
Skive means when you thin out the leather, the edges. You really, really trim. And, you know, obviously you can tell that it's sandwiched between the background leather being cognac here, but we really trim it so it doesn't look like a thick patch, like a fixer-upper. And if you see, I don't want to mention names, but any mass-produced boot, they don't skive it. They don't trim it. So it looks like a thick patch, makes the shaft kind of bend down, kind of wallow a little. Besides the pride of being one of a kind.
Totally. It has those little bits of human element with the way that you've made this boot. The one thing that I did notice was that this little smudge on the toe right here.
Yes, sir.
How does something like that happen from the finishing on this boot?
Most of those mass produced, they pre-finish them. They do that finishing, the sole itself, they just glue, bond them on. So even the stitching sometimes is just for show. Mm-hmm. It's already stitched on the welt and then they just bond it. But there's less to mess up the boot because it's just bonded after the fact.
Another thing that I want to talk about is your signature or a bootmaker's signature along the tongue of this boot. Can you talk to a little bit about that?
You are right. We call the crown of the BAMP the Floreta. And also the toe bugs. We can come up with a different toe bug per customer because we also do some private label for some companies, and they also want their boots unique. So even though we make them for them, they're unique to their own label.
Can you say who you make boots for, like what private labels?
Planet Cowboy, they're in Soho.
Okay.
There's some in Texas, I can't really tell their names, but there's Tim's Boots in El Paso. There's some in Fort Worth, Dallas. We used to make Santa Fe Boot Company. They closed a few years back, but we worked with them for 10 years or so. There's some in Philly, Philadelphia.
Wow, okay.
So, yeah.
What would this retail for at one of those places? Do you have any idea of what they would charge for a boot like this?
The fact that it has that premium touch, the logo, we're probably talking in the $750 to $900 range.
Wow, okay. Where can people find out more about BNV Boots? Like, how do they get a hold of you?
It's in Bravo Nancy Victor Boots at gmail.com, and as well as my phone number. And another plus, I think, in our production is 100% U.S. made. We're in El Paso, Texas, boot country. Perhaps your viewers are not aware that this is boot country, you know, legendary. It's not the last year. This has been boot country for 100 plus years.
Lots of history in cowboy boots in El Paso. I love it. Jose, thanks so much for your time. I really appreciate this. This is really going to be a great video.
Really appreciate your time, Jeremiah. I appreciate that you're giving us a little voice.
And these boots are epic. Then came show day. Jeremiah Craig and the Rusty Crowbars at the Jungle in Somerville, Massachusetts. Oh, it's our first show ever. I wore these boots. I was feeling so good, and the show was spectacular. We'll be right back. sure to check out our full live set when I wore these boots for the first time out at the link above, or wait till the end. It was an incredible show. You're gonna love it. Overall, I love the first Jeremiah Craig boot made by BNV Boots. The water buffalo hide is so elastic and so soft, it forms to the foot. I absolutely love the J-toe and the heel and the fact that it is traditionally made. It is a spectacular boot. I am not so concerned anymore with the smudge on the toe. It's gonna get scuffed up anyways, so it's not that big of a deal to me. The feel, the fit, everything else about this boot has totally won me over and pretty much helped me forget that there is a smudge on this toe at all. A lot of you have asked me when I'm gonna be releasing my own cowboy boot line, and I gotta be honest, it's not gonna be for a very long time. But as companies approach me with collaboration opportunities like this, I use them as learning opportunities so I know the best type of boot to release when I finally do collaborate with a company on a cowboy boot line. Now, the BNV boot, I am calling this the 0.1 beta boot. The first release cowboy boot that I ever release will be a 1.0. So this is beta, very early beta. And the reason why I can't pursue doing a line with BNV Boots is because this boot would retail at around $700. And I can't bring myself to release a boot and charge that much for it. Eventually, if I do release a cowboy boot line, and that's a big if, I would want the price of the boots to be around $200. I want them to be affordable, and I want them to have a good quality value to them, like my first boulets. I basically want to release a boot that's like my first boulet that can handle a bunch of shit, but not cost you an arm and a leg, and look good at the same time. And this looks great. It is spectacular, but it is too expensive to pursue a line with BNV Boots right now. Now, that said, if you want to talk to Jose about getting your own custom boot, here is his email and he can make you whatever you want, down to your littlest customization. And he was a great guy to work with. He's got lots of examples and he's just a nice guy. I mean, you saw him talk earlier in this video. Thank you so much for watching today. Let me know what you think of the first Jeremiah Craig boot. This is the 0.1 beta boot. Let me know down in the comments. Also, don't forget to check out my first live show with Jeremiah Craig and the Rusty Crowbars. It was a spectacular time and I was wearing these boots for the entire set. Thanks so much for watching today. Don't forget to subscribe and I'll catch you next time. Peace.